Elaine. President Obama's visit to Cuba next week comes after recent government crackdowns against political dissidents in the communist country. Human rights advocates want the president to speak out against the abuse and use America's power as leverage. Heather Sells brings us that story.
Since President Obama resumed relations with Cuba in late 2014, government persecution there has only increased. Since November, political arrests have spiked, reaching more than 1,100 arrests a month. And so far, 2016 is on course to be a record-setting year for human rights abuse.
I mean, the fact that there are still people being imprisoned in the Western Hemisphere, 90 miles away from America, simply for what they believe, I think all of this should be of great concern.
Critics charge the president's move has actually encouraged this attack on basic rights. Dr. Jaime Suchliki says Cuban President Raul Castro fears the new openness with the U.S. will embolden his opponents.
He's worried that the Cubans will get activated because of this relationship, and they'll be trying to defy the regime.
Once the crackdown began, we should have pulled back, and we should have said, we're not going to strengthen our relations with you unless you move in the right direction.
Many questions surround the president's historic visit, and they include what will he and what won't he say about human rights, and who will he meet with?
If he gets to meet with dissidents, if he actually speaks out about human rights, he can have a major impact. He can loosen up that society. He can embolden dissidents, and he can put that regime, as it should be, on the defensive.
The fact that our government, and at right now where it's in a position of greatest leverage, that the Cuban government wants as much as it wants so much from us, we can and we should be asking for these improvements.
Others, like Suchliki, see the president's ability to drive change as limited.
Obama will tell Raul, look, we need to improve in that area. Raul will say, sure, and that's the end of it.
Castro plans to step down in 2018. Suchliki believes the priority of maintaining control and a smooth transition will trump any move to improve human rights. Obama supporters, however, believe a push towards greater communication and economic ties could lead to political independence one day and improved human rights for now. Heather Sells, CBN News.